The history of the program is important to appreciate. It predates the department, in fact, and came out of collaborations between biochemistry and chemistry dating back to the 50s and 60s. So we've a long history in teaching and education in this area. And at that time, things like vitamin C purification, penicillin, products we're all aware of these days. Obviously, times have moved on, and we're now thinking more advanced, more complex biological molecules are increasingly important for cell and gene therapy, vaccines. So the MSc targets that need, that need that has grown and continues to grow over the years, to bring people from science, from engineering disciplines, and to help them make this transition into this very rapidly and very important area of bioprocessing. Primarily, it is an appreciation of the importance of the sector to meet the challenges the world is facing to manufacture these new products. A desire to get into the area, I would say, is the primary criteria to see people understand what they're getting into when they're applying.
I would say if they're interested in more like production of proteins, how the cell works and the industrial aspect of biology, not the basic biology where you do only research, then you get best of both worlds. You get the biological part, you get the applied part, as well as the modern equipment used. ICM accreditation helps you to connect with the entire group of chemical engineers all over the world, helps with jobs and also with different types of placements and consultancy. So that gives you basically a kind of extra edge over others who are doing normal chemical engineering or without ICM accreditation.
So it's quite broad for the MSc because we have three streams, and broadly speaking, those three streams allow us to accommodate scientists, chemists, to life scientists, accommodate for engineers, so process engineers, chemical engineers. We're very pleased that most go on into the industry. There's a broad range of companies that people may go and work for, from GSKs, Eli Lilly's of this world, the big biopharma companies, through to engineering consultancy type companies and design engineering companies. I won't go for the names, you'll be less familiar with them, through to small companies that are just sprouting up. In the London area, there's a lot of cell and gene therapy companies growing very rapidly at the moment that imply affording quite a lot of opportunities for employment.
Here, the first thing I would say is that it's a multicultural university. You get people from all over the world. So you get to meet people from different backgrounds, different culture, different qualifications. So that in a cohort, you get a person from a basic science background, a person from chemistry background, you get a person from pure engineering background like chemical engineering or mechanical engineering, or you get a person from a totally different like computer science, which I feel is the best part of being in a multidisciplinary, multicultural university.